Hello, my name is Hentai-Umi. I am a cyborg. Welcome to the GizzVerse Podcast. The show dedicated to the King Gizzard and the Lizard Wizard universe.
Yo, man, hot take. I honestly think that album is the best album that they've come out with.
We need more cookie!
A multi-dimensional universe with an invisible face.
Welcome to an altered future, brother.
Once created by a band, is now sustained by its fans.
Uh-oh. I hear the road train a-coming, baby. It's a-coming!
Open the door to your mind, pause. Here are your hosts, Tommy O'Neill and France in front.
You thought we were gone. Well, we were back. We came back like a diamond, baby.
Shine bright. I heard that
like
one.
A diamond.
Shine bright like a diamond.
Like whatever song you sing before the podcast starts, dude, my mix board just blew up right now.
It was so
loud that it just like it tried to fix itself and went straight down. And then was like, wait, how are you talking right now? How loud are you going to talk for the next five?
I only heard static. Yeah, it was wild.
Stay steady.
Shit, man.
Stay steady.
Started with a bang,
guys?
Baby.
Welcome to the GizzVerse Podcast. Brian, how's it going?
Happy dude, I'm doing pretty here. Good, man. Pretty good, bro. We out here, buddy.
The steamy GizzVerse basement. Brian's in the steamy GizzVerse closet.
The lab.
The lab, baby. The lab, as we like to call it.
A lot of hard work in here. A lot of hard work.
I text our friend Brent. I was like, yo, man, let's hang out. I sent him a picture of my little football setup I got going on for football. And I don't even watch college football, but for NFL as well, I don't even like NFL that much. But it's just happened. We have like a little gaming area set up for me and my wife to play side by side next to each other because she really wants to play Fortnite, but she wants to play Fortnite right next to me. It can't be like in a different room or anything like that. So
obviously
we have the stations. Anyways, I sent him a picture of it, and he's like, yeah, man, I think I'm going to be camping this weekend. And I was like, camping? Like for fun? You live out
classic
outside.
Brent.
Homeless for fun? I can't do that, dude. That's insane. I can't believe people do that. I love it. I need to text them back too. That's good. I can't be connected to wilderness like that, dude. You know what I mean? Toilets exist. I can't do it.
I know. I do.
Are
love
you camping
a toilet.
For fun? Are you camping for fun? Don't.
If I could be real, there's a better chance where you live. Okay, like you can get me to camp. In Colorado with you guys. Here in Florida, I ain't doing that for fun, dude. No,
see,
I'm not.
You say that not living here, and I'm going to... there are bugs here that don't exist in... I feel like Florida, I have a handle on the type of bugs that are there. There's mosquitoes, for sure. There's giant, disgusting mosquitoes. You need to protect yourself from ticks, kind of. Out here, there's a whole other gear of insects. Because there's, like, deer and bears... And, like, weird wild animals that you've never seen before that live in the woods, like Bigfoot.
Hey.
And the insects that live on Bigfoot's back, if you come into contact with that, you're going to die. You're going to die immediately. So
yeah, you don't want that. No, I mean, that's true. I understand that.
Are
I
you
just
more
about
saying
sweating.
That for temperature-wise? You think the temperature's better out here, so it's...
Oh, yeah, I don't care. You know, but listen, I mean, we're the king of roaches out here, and you know that's not my thing, dude. So I could see a scorpion and be like, it's a fucking scorpion, you know? That roach affects me more, man.
That's true. Most people, when they think of roaches, they think of them like in their house. You know what I mean?
Yes.
Like it's not it, in Florida though. You just be walking down the sidewalk and there's a herd of roaches just.
Where are they going?
No, that's true. That's true. It is a little.
What's up, dude? We're going to your house.
But is your main? We'll see you in about 10 minutes, bitch. Is your main reason for not wanting to camp in Florida bug related or heat related?
Oh man, that's the unfortunate part is they go hand in hand. And it's not just a Florida thing, right? So, camping at the caverns, one of our buddies was telling us about a camping experience he had. He was like, "Yeah, dude, I went camping, man, and there was ticks." Ticks, that's a whole nother fucking ballpark, by the way.
That's like, what I'm talking about, dude.
Sure, that is an insect, of course, but like, whoa, that's a whole different thing. He's like, yeah, dude, and I got bit by
Lyme
two ticks.
Lyme disease, bro? Lyme disease?
I prefer lemons, you know? And he's like, listen, man, I got bit by, do you get, yeah, he got bit by two ticks in his ball bag. In his fucking ball bag. You know, so I'm like, whoa. I was like, so how was that handled? He's like, well, a really good buddy of
it's
mine.
A family
clearly.
Podcast, Brian. This is a family, it's a family podcast.
Right? Okay, yeah, so sorry. Guys, if you don't know what a ball bag is, it's a man's scrotum. It hangs from the pelvis. It's a sack that holds your baby makers.
Juicy.
Juicy, camping, hot. And he said, good buddy of his was like, yeah, dude, well, let's go just like burn him off. I was like, burn him off? Well, that's crazy, right? I was like, so how did that go? You have to burn him off, yeah. Or else like... Because you can pick them off and not get the whole tick because they're already inside of you. So you could just, like, rip off their tail and there's still tick inside of you that now it's even harder to get.
What the fuck?
Facts, dude. Yeah, so definitely go camping. I was like, so how did you get them out? He's like,
but
yeah.
For the record, you guys were camping at the time that he was telling the story. Am I right?
Dude, and not sober, bro. Like, not sober on the stuff that makes you think, if you know what I mean. And I'm like,
yeah.
Oh my God! This cannot happen to me, dude. I will not handle as well as this this elegant man. Because holy shit! So, buddy pulls up with a lighter. He's like, dude, I got it, man. He takes up. I think it was rum. I think it was like it might have been Captain Morgan actually. He's like, dude, I just fucking chugged a big old swig of that shit. My buddy just
shut the fuck up.
Burned the guy. He's like, I was like, it hurt, right? He's like, oh yeah, it definitely hurt, but like. He said the alcohol absolutely helped, and it's just it was kind of like tinged it off. You know, just like, ooh, ay. Some hairs came off, gnats came off. Camping's cool, man.
The ticks came off, though.
Yeah.
Yo, that's some
mission accomplished.
MacGyver shit. Did they look that up online, like, or did they just know that casually being at the campfire?
This is camping knowledge. And listen, man, to people that camp, it's not as big of a deal. I mean, in the ball bag, anything's a big deal, right? But one of our buddies, we were looking for water at the caverns. We're like, I wonder if there's like a lake. Probably a lake. He's like, he's a journeyman, so he walks. He's like, I'll walk and I'll be back. He comes back, dude, and he's like, man, I got ticks all over me, bro. They're on his legs. That would have like sent me in panic. He's sitting there. We're talking for like an hour. He's just grabbing the ticks off, and it's just looking at his legs, bloody. There's like bloody legs. I'm like, dude, this is crazy, my man.
Christ, bro. That's insane, man.
That's hardcore,
insane.
Right?
And then they're like, yeah, man, I can't wait for next year, bro. This is going to be sick, bro. Yeah. Like, what, dude? Are you fucking insane? Like, people die from that shit. Like, there are diseases that bugs give you that you'll die from. Look at me. I'm not your dad. You know what I mean? Don't camp, guys. All right? Don't camp.
I used to camp.
Do it, and I'm not like this prissy guy that like lived this rich life. Don't get it flipped, man. My mom forced me to fucking camp my whole goddamn childhood.
Backwoods camping.
It was the fucking worst. I lived on a have you ever slept on a riverboat? Mosquitoes? Okay, you want to talk about holy shit, dude. There's no reason to do it, guys. There's no reason to do it. If you need a place to stay, we can figure something out for you, okay? We're not talking about the homeless thing. That's a whole other – maybe you should camp on that point. You know what I mean? That's not what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
But
city camping.
If you can avoid it, geez Louise, a peasy booze, don't camp. It's the worst. I can't believe people do it for fun. I'm impressed. I guess I should be – I'm impressed that people do it for fun. You know what I mean?
See,
I guess
that's kind of where I'm at with it.
Yeah.
And, guys, this is all just a PSA for Tommy letting you know not to camp so you don't go to the shows. So you don't camp at like the Gorge and stuff. So we have all the room we need. You know, we find the
you
best
do whatever
spot now,
you want.
Know?
You do whatever you want. I've just decided that like King Gizzard is much they're appeasing to their fans. They'll bend. So to guys like me, they're gonna say, okay, well we got you, Tommy. We're gonna get you in a nice area where you can get housed up, get a nice shower, go see the show. You can fly out and everything's going to be okay.
Get your ass home. Yeah.
And get your ass home. And if you plan appropriately, like, I mean, that those things, speaking of which, those marathon tickets came out. Me and Brian were texting each other. Yo, man, you got it, right? You got it, man.
No.
We did not
tell me you got it,
take
right?
advantage of any. I mean, I think it's so crazy because, like, we could have easily purchased 10 tickets, right? And then just held on to them and sold them. The opportunity is there. I understand the inclination, but I'm glad we're not pieces of shit that do that, you know?
It helps, man. It helps. And that would generally crumble our podcast to pieces because those people get exposed, dude. Like, oh my God. That's so. Now, I will say, yes, like, that's so cool when you can be that person. This what's happened to both of us, where it's like, hey, I was that person that bought extra tickets. I have one for you, and here it is at the exact same value that I paid for it. Like, that's so damn nice. Because so, dude, some people literally they don't have exactly. Some people don't twice. Have $85 to $100 to pay that exact moment to get the tickets that they went on sale. You know, so like, it's awesome that people do that, and it is much appreciated. All across.
For me, it's more about life. Like, I don't want to buy something guaranteed. I'm going to be able to do it in a year and a half from now. And I'm like, oh, yeah, I'll definitely be up. Like, come on, man. Like, that's a long time for me to guarantee. But if I want to sit close to them, I have to do that. So,
yeah,
there's that bust. But here comes the thing is, like, I now know 100% guaranteed that I can sell that ticket for at least face value every single day of the week. Now, I'm going to say this on the podcast so everybody knows this, and I guess if you buy the ticket, you're going to know it. But if you buy a resale ticket, don't feel gypped if someone sells it to you for like $35 more than they bought it for, because that's how much they got charged in fees and fucking taxes. Ticketmaster,
fees, man.
How do they sleep at night? What the fuck is wrong with them? The ticket was $65. It jumped up to $95. I can't fucking believe that. That's an insane thing to happen. I'm not blaming King Gizzard. I'm not blaming King Gizzard, because what happens is you work with these venues and they're locked in with Ticketmaster. They have these like fucking 10-year contracts, and then slowly behind the scenes, Ticketmaster's ramping up the fees and shit. So now it comes down to the people that want to go see. I don't think King Gizzard wants to charge $95 to go see them. I don't think that was their goal. I don't think so either, right? I don't think so either. You don't think so. We both don't think so.
We both don't think so. I mean, these tickets at these venues that they're playing at, that's how much tickets cost at these venues. I will say a good buddy of the podcast mentioned that they're playing at Forest Hills in New York, which is they played there last year as well. And she said the tickets went up literally double the price. It's like, damn, dude. I think they were like $45 last year. They're like $90 this year. It's like, man, you know, that's that is kind of shitty. But that comes with the exposure, man. What are you going to do, right? We knew it would happen. We knew it would happen.
Is the New York – that's a marathon set, though, right?
It is.
So was it a marathon set last time?
You know what? That's a really good point, actually. I didn't even think about that. I actually don't think it was.
So that's what I – and I didn't think so either, but I didn't want to – dude – just to clarify here on the pod, I mean, I have my iPod over here. I have notes over here. I can't keep everything on the top of my head. There's too much shit about this band for me to keep it all 100%. So there is going to be some times we don't know some stuff, guys. Like, you know, but
is
we
that
do
what
wanna,
it was?
We're going to be bringing people on in the near future. We keep teasing that, but don't you worry. Just like King Gizzard, we always come through. We're going to give you guys what you want. We know you want to come on the podcast and share your stuff, so that's going to come as well. But I believe New York, the last one wasn't a marathon set. And if you're
I'm pretty
gonna,
sure it wasn't.
Right. So then they probably played an hour, hour and a half, which is half of 3 hours. So if they're going to be playing 3 hours, then maybe they should be charging
bring
double.
Your wallet.
Understandable that I'm saying that as a person that is charged by the minute before, which is, and that sounds sexual, but it's not. I'm not, don't even go there, guys. Back off, all right? We're not talking.
Take it easy, huh?
You can charge by the word, you know? But anyways, if you're looking at your time valued and stuff and whatnot, they're playing 3 hours. And those marathon sets are no fucking joke. They're amazing shows. They show up. They pound it. They do a great job. So we can't sit here on our high horse and be like, hey, you know, what? But I get the concern. And I'm not shitting on the person that you were having this conversation with about the difference. I appreciate the cost thing, too, because that does fucking suck. However,
it adds up. And it's really just one of the expenses, right? I mean, unless it's like in your hometown, but still,
that's the real
getting way. Out, dude. It's a lot. These gorge shows in Washington, bro, I mean, how far is a plane ride from Orlando, Florida to Washington? And it's not like you get off in the airport and it's like right there. If from what everybody's saying, there's not a lot of Airbnb, not a lot of hotels around there. This is a camping one. So like, am I flying with camping material? Am I gonna buy it when I get out there? Like, it's a lot of moving parts. We have a year to think about it for sure, but it's like, that is an expense. It's like it's like a vacation. You make a vacation around King Gizzard, and it's like it's very fun. Generally, nothing makes me happier, but it's a lot. It is a lot. It is an expense.
I'm gonna clip that and send that to Emily. Thank you for saying that live on the podcast. Nothing makes you happier. Anyways,
She'd be like, bitch, I know. No, for sure.
That is the clip, baby. Clip of the episode. Washington is a lot farther. When, you know, I hear Washington, I think east, north or northeast, but that's not the not real Washington. So I forget that it's over there next to Portland.
It's a journey.
But it's pretty there. There are some rough spots. I'll just say that. There are some rough spots in Washington. I don't know if you've ever been there before, but a beautiful place.
The gorge looks gorge.
Amazing.
For lack of a better term. Whoa, dude. I mean, it's considered like one of the – I was reading an article today. It's like top five venues in the world to go see a band or just be at. And I'm like, it's going to be groovy, man. It's going to be damn groovy up in there.
I'm excited for you. I'm definitely not going. one marathon set is good enough for me. I just know myself. The more I know about these camping experiences, they sound awesome for other people. I like hearing the stories. I want to talk about it with people. I love obviously with me, talking is my love language. So I enjoy listening to people and their telling me about their lives and all that stuff. So that's something that I really enjoy. But I don't need to experience it personally in order to enjoy it. I've learned that about myself. I'm more of a campfire kind of guy. I sit at the campfire, smoke a cigar, drink a whiskey, and you tell me, and Jesus, you know, just tells me that he got beat up and got put on the cross. I'm like, damn, bro, that's fucking wicked crazy, dude. You know?
That's hardcore. That's wicked crazy, dude.
That's wild, dog. I want to be that dude, you know what I'm saying? And then I'll tell people that about that story, you know what I mean? But I don't want to – that sounds like I want to be a preacher. That's not what I'm talking about. But you guys get the metaphor I'm trying to express here. Camping, it just sounds terrifying to me, you know?
I get it.
God bless. I'm going to give Brent a couple weeks to see if he's got Lyme disease, and then I'm going to invite him back over.
And then we'll check him out.
See what's going on.
Check him out. We'll see. To Tommy's point, he's not totally wrong. Unfortunately, I have such FOMO, fear of missing out, that like I have to do, even if it's like outside of my comfort zone, I have to be there because I just can't miss it. I get grumpy. But let me tell you something. If you do go camping, a great benefit to you is to go camping with people who have camped before. Somebody like Brent, a sweetheart of a man, gear is one that's great, but the knowledge is way more valuable than the fucking gear, man. Brent was like, hey, dude, why don't you move your tent a little this way? I think that right there is poison ivy. So if you just move it this way, he's like, oh, yeah, that right there, that whole little section is poison ivy, man. So if you want, he's like, I should probably rip it out in a little bit. Just throw on some gloves, I'll rip it out in a little bit just to be safe. But I'll just move the tent maybe like 4 or 5 feet this way, and you'll be good to go. Like, dude, I'm like, thank you, man. That's excellent. I had no fucking idea. It all looks the same to me, so... Very cool. So you want those little tads of knowledge in your mix. It's very nice.
We've built up an image of Brent on the in my phone. I have him saved as Brent the Hitman Hart. We have built up an image of Brent on this podcast. Just a side note, that's one of my favorite wrestlers of all time. That is a huge fucking compliment. And Brent, I love the dude. So. It's going to be really interesting when we bring him on the podcast and actually sit down and talk to him, because you'll understand completely, he's fitting a lot of different categories all at once. Trust us, it's gonna make sense in the long run. Just
100%.
Stick with us, you know.
Ride with us, guys. Ride with us, man.
I went to a gem show. This is the last thing I want to tell you before
we
get into some of the next year.
The like big ass, like gigantic one?
Is it?
It's like a rock and mineral show. I went to it, dude.
The fossil one?
It was like at the, I don't know what it's called. It's like a convention center kind of fucking. Oh my God. Like 12 miles of tables. It has to be the same
fucking
thing.
Okay, well, you seem excited about it. I get strapping because I'm about to shit all over it. It was literally like, it was a flea market for rocks. I was so confused. Yes. I was just walking through the whole thing like, and a ton of hustling and bustling, as I would put, like a lot of wheeling and dealing, and you know, like yesterday was 100%, today was 50% off or whatever. Like,
sick.
It was crazy, dude. It was just immediately I didn't get the vibes. You know, I see some like hippies, I see some mostly ladies in the environment. There's a lot of guys I see that are running, you know, little cubicle rock things or whatever their display area. I should break this down what it looks like first so to fully understand. It's three floors of just a few thousand square feet per floor, and each floor just has a bunch of people setting up their own individual like mineral displays. Some is
yep.
art, some are just rocks, some are, you know, little skulls made of rocks, but they're all rocks. But everything, you know, has a little, and it's like, you know, the where you bust open a rock, go to the museum, and you see inside, it's like purple
oh, yeah.
little diamonds in there. And
pretty.
Like, ooh. The thing yes. that everybody has seen at the Science Center when they're fucking 10. I was like, all right, that's cool, I guess. And there was just a ton of those, and they like fashioned them into seats or something. Did you see the seats?
I saw the seats, bro. I saw they were pricey, but of course, I mean, it's like a whole thing.
That's
but.
The other thing. That's the other thing. Who the fuck goes there and spent? Now, some of the stuff was hilarious to me because I'd go, the 50% thing was killing me. I saw a giant thing, huge mineral display thing. This has a point at the end, guys. There's this huge mineral thing, and it was this big art display, and it was $39,000, and it was like $39.99. I was like, why do you need to put the 99? What's the fucking the use of the 99 cents at that point? Who fucking cares? Like, that's insane. Anyways.
Deal breaker. Like, no, I won't pay that.
It was 50% off. I'm like, just put $20,000 on that. That is so fucking stupid. Anyways, Phew. That was the whole – that I keep saying that word. I got like a tick. Everywhere you went, that was the deal. You'd go there, and everyone was just like hustling. But I'm like, who the fuck is buying this shit? And there was tons of people there, dude. Parking was impossible. We kept swerving. Oh, my God, dude. It was mostly, and no offense to anybody, but it was mostly because of the guys that were parking people. They didn't give a shit, bro. And I get it. They're probably making $7 an hour. They don't give a fuck. Totally understandable. I'm not shitting on anybody, but they were just like, they had no authority. People were just doing whatever the fuck they wanted. So traffic was just backed up trying to get in and out the parking lot. And then once you're walking, you realize how fucking terrifying everything is because cars are like, fucking get out of the way. And the whole time, dude, this is just getting in there. The whole time I was like, for rocks? For fucking rocks?
So funny,
we're doing
man.
It? This is insane, bro. What are we doing here? This is for fucking rocks? You know you can go in your backyard and fucking just dig for a little bit. You'll find some fucking rocks, dude. And then I was just, of course, I got in trashing it mode, and I just kept turning to my wife, be like, you want to fucking get your chakras aligned? Let's go get our chakras. She's like, and she's laughing, but at the same time, I don't want to like
God
ruin
damn it,
the
man.
Experience for
I can't take this guy anywhere, man.
Real fast, you know what I mean? So anyways, on the way out, I'm looking, and like we lasted like an hour, and she was like, yeah, I thought this would be different because the name is Mineral Rock and Fossil Show. Okay, when you say a show to me, there should be a show. There should be something like display.
Oh, you were okay.
This
I got you.
The name was completely deceptive. It should be more something like Rock Flea Market, Mineral Flea Market. We sell rocks here. We had no idea. So like that was completely deceptive. And then on the way out, like just walking through stuff, I see somebody with a King Gizzard shirt, and it's a lady. And I was like, oh, King Gizzard. She gave me the fucking, and I have to call you out, she gave me the dirtiest fucking look on the planet. And
people
I was
be
like,
doing
what,
that, dog?
Bro? Dude, it was so weird. I was like, oh, okay, word, son. It was so fucking bizarre, man. And I was like, dude, I don't understand this place, and I need to just get my chakras realigned before I come back in here, and I think that was my problem. So I went back in there, and I bought a $30,000 piece of rock, and I'm going to go get it right now on the podcast.
Fuck yeah.
Hell no, I didn't buy no rocks, man. Fuck that shit. Are you kidding me, dude? That was fucking insane. I'm glad I took fucking 5 minutes to tell that story. I am grateful that I did that. You're welcome, and I'm sorry if you fast-forwarded through it. You missed out. It was a joy.
Dude, it's so funny, man, because I went to the exact same
show.
You
had a great time. I'm sure you had a great time.
Dude, and it's just such a different experience. Like, I mean, granted, it's like you couldn't see it all. It's like they literally said it's like 12,000 feet of tables. I'm like, what does that mean? Like, who measured that? You know, that's like a lot of tables. But rock on. And it's just, again, Brent loves this stuff. And listen, there's so many people listening to this right now who eat this stuff up. They're like, man, this guy just don't get it, man. He just don't get it. You know, his chakras. That's why that girl looked at you like that, bro. Your chakras weren't aligned. She's like, dog, keep it moving, man. Keep it moving. You know,
Fuck dude, that. Right? Don't you dare stick up. Don't you dare stick
man.
Up.
100%, man. Dude, Emily bought some rocks, some really nice fucking
rocks
that we have displayed around our house that we put in our suitcase to come back home. Very
you
cool.
bought rocks, put it in your 100%. Suitcase, and dragged it back to Orlando.
Julia is sending us some through the mail. Yeah, man. Oh, yeah, dude. Oh, yeah. Brent and Julia bought this. Yeah, damn it. I hate this. It's so crazy because it's so tight. It's like a piece of wood with this, like, you have to see it. You will see it. You will see it. And I was like, yo, dude, that'd be pretty cool to cut up some. Dude, I listen, man. This is for GizzVerse After Hours, but I was
yeah,
like, yo,
no,
that'll
no,
be
no. A- yeah, let's keep that. Let's keep that off the.
I was like, listen, man, but that'd be a cool little tray. You know what I mean? Like, yeah, that's
yeah,
a good
yeah,
idea,
yeah.
man.
No, we get it. We get it.
$140 later, dude, that thing is with us. And
no.
It is. Wait till you see it, buddy. Wait, you got to see it, man.
I know. But don't twist it on me, because now I like Brent, and now you're making me. I wish you should have went first before I did all that. It is funnier. I got to be honest with you. The outcome of the story is a lot funnier this way, but I should have known ahead going into it. I wouldn't have went that hard in the paint. No, there are infest the rat's nest guys like me. There are guys who are like not like they're like, what the fuck are you talking about? And I even said that to Allison. I was like, that wasn't King Gizzard when we first got into this shit. That wasn't Gizzard. So for the yeah. And I'm not, you know, whatever. I don't need to start anything. But, like, for the record, that's a new thing to King Gizzard. That has not always been there. That this is a very new, I would say, branch that they've gotten in the last couple years. Am I mistaken when I say that?
No, not even. No, not even. And to tie it back to Rat's Nest, they had – I was like, oh, my God, here we go. I was like, I see Gizzard everywhere. They had an exhibit. It was, like, all, like, butterflies, like a bunch of, like, preserved butterflies. I was like, oh, butterfly 3000. Then maybe you saw this. There was like a bunch of it's not taxidermy. It's just like skeletons of animals and stuff. And one was like a rodent or yeah. And I was like, oh. And dude, I turned into this because it was like tied. Turned to the side, the exact rat's nest. I was like, this is tied. Boop. Took a picture, threw it on the gram. I was like, this is too perfect. It was too good.
I did take a picture of a giant. Carved out Gila monster. It's just this huge, like, 12-foot Gila monster. I'll post it on the Instagram as well.
King Gila, baby.
I thought it was hilarious, man. I thought it was a hilarious scene, baby.
Yeah, that's really fun. That's so funny that because I get it when you say show. I knew the show aspect of it because they'll say when they do that with records, for example, it's the like. The Orlando record show or whatever, you know what I mean? So like I thought I was going up in there to see some, for sure.
I thought I was going up in there to see some fucking dinosaurs. You know what I mean? Like some big ass dinosaurs and just be like, tight, dude, fucking
damn,
dinosaurs.
That's sick.
Went up in there and it was like, you know, $3. I got a jewel right here. And I'm like, bro, I don't know. What are you talking? Everybody was trying to like. That was also a thing that I don't like is everybody trying to sell you shit is not you pull up and look at something for 2 seconds. I'll get half off. What do you want? How much? I'll get whatever you want. Take it, please. It's like, bro, chill the fuck out. Like this is and we went on the last day. So people were just like, it was funny as hell seeing people like I kept thinking. Who bought this for full price? And now it's. Literally half because of the different day of the week. That's and maybe that's why it was a little more buck that particular day.
Oh,
it
for
was
sure,
the last.
Yeah. Whew. Oh, I bet.
For rocks, bro. For rocks, man. I don't know, dude. I don't know, man.
Listen, man. It's interesting, man. Different strokes, different folks, buddy. You know,
different strokes for different folks. I like brand new golf clubs. You know what I mean? For the same price as a brand new golf club, but some different strokes, see? Different folks. Rocks, they sit there. You can put stuff on it, you know, I guess. You can look at it, poke it, tell it good things. And
align your chi, bro. Your chi is not aligned, dude.
I got to be honest with you. I am so, like, happy and in the zone right now in life. It is the – I'm, like, super aligned with – I feel, like, very aligned with my chi.
With my chi.
But I am chi'd out. I'm so chi'd. I'm chi'd-o'd. You know what I mean, dude? I'm
chi'd-o'd.
So chi'd.
I get it, man.
I'm extra cheat. Don't talk shit to me about my cheat. You know what? I'm fucking done with
this
podcast.
Get your cheat together, bro. Go buy yourself a rock, man. Trust me,
just flip out and quit.
Goodbye.
Fuck
take your rocks,
man.
Show up your ass.
I'm fucking done with rocks, dude.
I kept singing Fell in Love with the Girl at the Rock Show. I sung that so many times. I was like, Hamley, fell in love with the girl at the rock show. Yeah, I had that going pretty good.
I played that in the middle school talent show.
Hell yeah.
Covered that. Isn't that dope? Just to let you know, dude. Just to let you know how I roll, dog.
Simpler days, man. Simpler days.
Shut the fuck up. You don't got to judge. King Gizzard didn't exist then, guys, okay? I was in middle school.
You don't understand.
Don't fucking judge me, okay?
So but let me tell you something, buddy. King Gizzard exists now. They exist now, and we're happy to have them, man.
We were going to do the same thing. I was transitioning too. That's so funny, bro. That's hilarious.
That's it, man. That's what we do, bro. It's our nuclear fusion, brother. It's all right, man. You know?
I was going to say we know about the upcoming giant shows that are going to come up, the marathon sets. You're going to go
breaks,
to two of
said.
Them.
Minimum.
You're going to go to two of them. Maybe. Probably. But you feel confident if you can't go to – you're going to go to Austin though, right?
Austin is the one that is 150% sure.
And we're going to talk
Emily
about this.
Emily loves Austin. We love it. Yeah.
Do you want? Okay. Well, let's just talk about this right now then. I'm excited to talk about it. We're definitely going to do a meetup in Austin. We've already been kind of talking to people in the background. We're going to nuclear fuse with a few different entities, and we're going to make this shit pop. Last time, we didn't even really do a meetup. We just people kind of did it on their own a little bit and kind of got together, and that was – we saw just people getting together, and that was pretty cool.
Amazing.
But the time before that, when we did the podcast, I'm not even kidding. They were telling us like 600 to 800 people. Like they were turning people down. It was an insane thing. So
filthy.
Just to be clear, we're going to do that again, but we're going to make sure the venue's big enough to house that many people. I don't know how we're going to do it. We're going to figure it out, guys, because we want you to have fun there. That's the big thing. And everybody showed up and had a great time, but it was just a little constricted, and we didn't know there was going to be that many fucking people. So we're going to design it better this time. We fucking promise. And the vendors, we're going to reach out on our Instagram and other social media.
Hell yeah. There's going to be goodies
up in
there.
As well as the podcast. And we're going to talk with you guys and make sure we have enough tables. That's the whole reason we want you guys to it's not like a power trip or anything like that. But that's the whole reason we want to talk, is to make sure that we have enough tables for everybody to be there as well. Because we don't want anybody to feel slighted where they're just like sitting on a chair and selling, you know, whatever they want to sell off of chairs. We want to have everybody
for sure.
Have an opportunity. So anyways, because neither of us live in Austin, it's going to be a little tricky sticky sometimes. But I think we're going to be able to get it done. We've got some
good
friends
hands.
Over there. Got some I got some air miles that I'll probably have to burn in the
Hey-o.
Process. But
love
we
that.
Also, the internet exists, so it's going to be a good time. I think it's going to be a really fun meetup. So I encourage you, if you haven't bought a ticket to a marathon show and you're trying to figure it out, Austin might be the one. If it's not sold out yet, I know the Pit's sold out, but Austin might be the one for you to go to, because this meetup is going to be off the fucking chain. It's going to be sick. It's going to be really GizzVerse. You're going to want to be there. So that's I'm throwing out my recommendation. I'm sure Brian feels very similar. Anything else you want to throw in there?
That's what I'm most excited for about this trip. Of course, we don't know what other dates they're going to add, what venues they're going to add. That's all great. But that Austin, I mean, we look for any excuse to get out there. I'm pretty sure the Side Goodies guys will all be there. Bren will be there. All of our camping homies from Caverns will be there. Like, it's gonna be a really, really fun time, man. I'm super duper stoked about it, actually. A 3-hour marathon set would really hit the pace. I don't know what other they might do other shows in Austin or in Texas right around that time. So like, that's what we have to, obviously we'll be preparing for this, but just make sure they're not like somewhere. I don't know. We gotta see a lot of things still, obviously, but
yeah.
Very exciting, man.
We're gonna figure it out. But either way, we'll do it. We'll plan it right to where it's in the afternoon-ish, if necessary, because we might have to start planning it before they release their full U.S. tour. We'll get into that in a moment. And if we have to do that, we're going to have to play it a little earlier on in the day. And I know if everyone wants to get wrecked up, that might work out perfect, because you can come to the meetup, get wrecked, and then go to the show and have a great time. So that all sounds like a fun-ass time. If we just have to end it a little earlier than we want. Because the last time the meetup just went, and I think we want to repeat that again. I think that would be fun if we can get there like the day before and do it. that would be...
I think the day before is the way. That was in, like, Miami, and, like, Denver was like that, too. It's nice. I think that's nice. So then people... Because, you know, dude, some of the Giz fans, man, you know how some of us get down, bro. They're like, oh, the show's at 8? Cool, I'm going to be there at 7 a.m. You know, so
get
it's like, you want to make sure everybody gets a chance. You want to make sure everybody gets a chance to go to both of the things they want to go to. So, yeah, I love the day off. It takes that stress of like, oh, my, okay, so should we get out of here? But, again, a lot of moving parts, but it's going to be a damn blast, 100%.
I will say, because Austin and the way the seating situation is, when I saw it online, it's a little different than Red Rocks, so it's not the pressure to get there. I got to get there so early that nobody else gets my seat, and there are some other shows that are going to be like that. So, but I think Austin's a little more seated, which might make it easier for people. Just another reason why maybe Austin might be the marathon set for you. Anyways.
Yeah, <man. laughs> it's going to be sick, man. And these venues are pretty big, these, like, the marathon shows particularly. So for a lot of people, like, last year when or this year, the Caverns sold out so fast. That really bugged people. It was really unfortunate. These are, I think, Gorge is, like, 27,000. Austin is, like, 15,000, if I remember correctly, capacity. So it's, like, what will sell out and what did sell in Austin was the pit. So I'm so glad we jumped on that early. People, like, minutes after we were like, yo, dude, we got them sick. We're like, damn, missed out on Pit. Like, they'll still be there, of course. But, like, I feel really fortunate that we got those. And it's going to be super-duper fun, man.
I'm excited, man. I'm genuinely excited. I think this has enough preparation time. We're obviously going to be – we're going to drop a new shirt, which we're really excited about. We've been working on it in the background for quite some time with our good buddy – 10 yards, just a little.
The homeboy.
This is going to be a good one, guys. This is going to be a good one. We're very excited for that as well. It's just going to be a good time. We got plenty of time to prep, and I'm a prepper, a person that likes to be prepared. I could say it a different way.
I'm mad at that.
Yeah, I'm not. I like that. I'm an organizer. I like to be with it. So, and there is going to be some stuff. It's going to be a good time. We'll talk about it. We got plenty of time to go over that stuff. While I got you on the phone, Brian, let me ask you. King Gizzard, we know the shows that are coming, the marathon shows. You just actually said something that's interesting. I didn't even think about it, but they might do shows within Texas or within Austin additionally to the marathon set. I didn't even think about that. But when I was getting ready to purchase the Gorge show, you said, well, keep in mind they haven't released – their other show dates. That was a really good point, and that's what made me not pull the trigger on the Gorge, to be honest with you, because I was like, oh yeah, I'm gonna go to a ton of whatever shows they got, and they might come back to Red Rocks, they might not,
maybe,
but they should definitely come back to Colorado. They sell out every time they're here. Why wouldn't they come make a little
for sure
cha-ching ba-jing? And Red Rocks would be like, yeah, sure, whatever you want.
Whatever, dude.
I've seen other shows there. They would be like,
we know,
yes,
buddy.
Please come back. Please come back, Mr. Gizzy. Please come back. They want them to, for sure. I don't know what accent that was. This is a good one.
I don't know.
So it did make me – let's keep that in mind. They're obviously going to come back to Denver. They're going to go to Texas, and they might hit the spots that we already know. Brian, where maybe – are some spots where they would go that, you know, we haven't seen them yet, or maybe we have seen them in the past,
okay,
and they're going to return to. Either one's fine with me for an answer. I just like hearing your opinion on the matter. However, if you give me a new spot, it's an extra point. Ding, ding, bing, bing.
Okay. Ooh, nice. You know, I haven't even chewed on a new spot, so I like that. Actually, yes, I have. New spot, Orlando, fucking Florida. How about that? All right.
That's what I was hoping you were going to say there, buddy.
There we go. On. Yeah, easy. Layup, yeah.
I fed you the cookie crumbs.
and daddy hungry. Yeah, no, for sure. Love to see him in Orlando. I know that's going to be a tall request, unfortunately. I don't totally see in the cards. But they do remember where we saw him? And sorry, everybody, don't get triggered. This was, I think, maybe over 10 years ago at this point. Remember the amphitheater in Tampa where we saw Kanye and Lupe and NERD?
Hell yeah.
They are right around that place. I think the capacity there is 20,000. If they go to the Gorge, now, of course, way more people go to the Gorge than Tampa, Florida. But, like, I think if not this year, I think we will see them there at some point. That's, like, our backyard, so I would love to see them there. That'd be awesome. So, yeah, I'll put that in my back pocket. I'll grab the point for that one. I want to see them again, no question about it, Atlanta. we have a little base in Atlanta of like friends and people that we generally fuck with over there. I look for any excuse to get to Atlanta. We've seen them multiple times now in Atlanta. Run it back. Unfortunately, it won't be the same venues. Variety Playhouse back in 2018, whatever year that was amazing. Tabernacle was a shit show. Amazing. They can't do those venues anymore. It hurts my heart to say it, but it would sell out like this, and it would just be diabolical in there. But Atlanta's got some little bigger venues.
They're not making enough money. We've talked about that.
It doesn't make sense.
They're not making enough money doing that.
It's like I always say in my head, like, oh, man, but how – it's so keeping it real if you do it. But no, because, like, you're not making the dough you deserve, and the fans, not enough for the people that want to see you can see you. So nobody wins. Like, I mean, the people there win, I guess, but, like, that's not fair.
I'm going to throw another thing out there real quick. Think about his wife and his kids. They're leaving their family behind on these giant tours that they go on. They're stopping their life completely.
Yep.
Their personal lives completely for a very long period of time. If you're going to do that, if you're going to justify being away from your children and their life is dissolving away in front of you and you don't even get to be around it, you better be able to justify it financially. And they've done the work. We've watched them grow. We've watched them put in the work. So I think for that too, that is a big component that I would throw in there. Anyways, please continue.
Yeah, 100% agree. That's a very solid point, actually. Atlanta's one of them. You mentioned Denver. Yeah, they're going to be back there. I think they will add some kind of cool – because they're also really in for the ride, man. Like, this run this year, they did Caverns, Red Rocks, like venues that they think are sick, that they've wanted to play their whole lives. So I think that'll continue. I think the Gorge is that next one for them. So that's fun. These New York shows, they added, I remember we talked about this, they added a second New York marathon show the night before. So it's like, nice. I think it's like a Friday, Saturday. So it's like, damn, dude, that really does make it worth the time to get out there, no question about it. I was thinking about, like, even just like you and me, like, I was like, man, me and Bone would have a fun time. We've never been to New York together. You know, like, we probably have a wild, kooky time. Similar to, like, San Francisco, like, when we saw them at Fillmore. I think we could definitely recreate that in New York and be like, this is kind of crazy, man. You know, It's crossed my mind a couple times for sure. I can't really think of any other like venues. The ones that are near and dear would be close. Like something I could drive to, I would love. You know what I mean? For selfish reasons only. Like they did Miami what was that 2 years ago or whatever. That was awesome. You know what I mean? And Miami's not. I don't love Miami, but it's like 3 hours. It's not ideal, but it was a blast. Our first meetup was held there. That was fucking killer. So, I don't know. For me, it's just close. It would be great. You have any I know Denver, obviously, in the back pocket. Any other venues around Colorado or right outside Colorado you'd be interested in seeing? Like, any places you would travel to go see?
Absolutely. Great question. So, Las Vegas, when we saw them in Vegas outdoors like that, it was a very, very cool experience. And the lights, I'm not like a Vegas guy. I don't like to gamble or anything like that.
Right.
But it was really cool just being around that atmosphere, and I've never been, you know, tripping in that atmosphere before. So that was also I didn't know if I'd be overwhelmed and just like, ooh, the cigarettes, they're killing me. It wasn't. It was just a very cool, very awesome experience. The lights were really fucking, you know, sick. Outside at the cabana, orb open for fucking Pond, and then Gizzy showed up. Like, that is a phenomenal. I'd love to see something like that where it's in a city that maybe they have a friend in that is just happening to roll in through town and they do something like that again. Because Pond wasn't opening up for them the whole tour.
No.
But we've seen, like in Los Angeles, when you go see a show there, it's really interesting because you'll see, you know, big time bands on a smaller stage and a smaller venue and then other cool celebrities, you know. It's really neat when that happens.
Yep.
I know that sounds cheesy or whatever, but it's really cool when it fucking happens. It pops off. And I'd love to see them on that kind of stage again. I'd love to see them in a Vegas type arena. And I'm not saying small stage because let's be real. Like that, the amount of people there were small, but the venue was big. They could have sold that shit out and it would just be, you know, a few thousand people there. It would be awesome. I think it would be a buck ass time. Utah, I think, has some really cool outdoor spaces that they could play at. I would
yep.
out outdoors is where I'm cool with seeing them right now. However, is it the Paramore we saw them at in San Francisco?
This Fillmore.
Is the Fillmore. Paramore. I think it's a band. Sorry, guys. I'd love to see them at the Fillmore again. I'd love to see them at the Fillmore.
It's dirty.
You know, where did we see them in L.A. that was super huge? The L.A.
Greek Theater?
The Greek Theater?
We saw Greek Theater and Palladium. Palladium was lit.
No, the Palladium. The big one. The Palladium was the big one, right? Yeah. I'd love to see them at the Palladium again. That shit was awesome because it was a perfect.
That was great.
The way they build it, it's standing.
Yep.
So, and they have, you know, the upper theater or whatever. But it's like this. So people gradually go up so you could still see the band wherever you're at. It's a perfect place to see a fucking epic band. And the sound system was perfect for them.
Rocking for them.
Show rocking. Rocking, dude. And the people were rocking. And the coolness. Again, this sounds cheesy because it sounds like I'm like bragging on L.A. And if you ask me about L.A. right now, I would not say the things I'm saying right now. Because it doesn't exist anymore. It's just a different place. Walking out of that show and just seeing everybody and the electricity and every part of the show and going out into the and just looking at the Hollywood signs, it's just fucking awesome. And getting on the train and heading down to K-Town, it's fucking sick, man. The whole experience.
Wild
I'd
shit.
Love to see them in that environment again. And then the same goes for San Francisco, is the walking around, the leaving, the wow, like what the fuck. Dude. This is an awesome place. And I think New York, like you said, would have that vibe, would definitely have that feeling of like walking, like, man, wow, look how dirty this place is now.
It's really crazy, falling apart. Dude.
Sorry, I shouldn't have done that. I'm sure it's a great place, but it's not looking good right now. They're a little tough. AOC's having a tough job over there. I saw them.
Tough gig, man.
Popping off. I don't know anything about politics, by the way, guys. I'm not saying. I just see videos of people yelling at people, and I'm like, geez.
Oh, shit, man.
Why are people mad? I don't know what's going on. I'm more worried about rocks, okay? That's what I'm mad about. I'm not
see,
mad
that's
about
his whole thing.
Anything. I'm mad about people in line in cars to go get rocks. That's the only thing that I'm really upset about. You know what I mean?
That's your first mistake, man, you know?
That's my first mistake. So those are a few venues that I can immediately think of and that I wrote down. Anything out of that, I feel, would be too much of a stretch for them to even hit. New Mexico would be sick. There's a few venues
that'd be
in
nice,
New Mexico
huh?
that are dope. Santa Fe might be dope. They have a Meow Wolf there. Not that they could play in Meow Wolf. I'm saying you can go to Meow Wolf and then go see King Gizzard. That might be sick.
They could do it, man. They could do it. You know?
They could do it, but it's like the venue is like, you know, 100 people deep or whatever.
Amazing, man.
Very
what a dream.
Easy. Hard to sell out because it costs extra money, but easy to sell out if you're, you know. If King Gizzard did a Meow Wolf show, bro, that would be the fastest selling out experience ever. You'd have to get those tickets so fucking fast. It'd be crazy,
hell
bro.
Yeah.
It'd be crazy.
Yes. It'd be sick. We'd be trying very hard to get there. Let's put it that way. Very
that
hard.
That might be a dream.
Us and 40,000 others.
I'd be down to see that. That might be a fantasy show that I'd be super. I just got to put that into the universe. You know what I mean?
Yes. Pay them enough. Put it in there, buddy. Yeah, right?
I mean,
sponsored by GizzVerse Podcast.
Sponsored by GizzVerse Podcast for fucking short. They're like, all right, mate, we get the money for the tickets. We get, you know, we got to pay them $100,000. They get the money for the tickets. They get the money for the merch. They get everything. You know what I mean? And it's still not enough.
All right, let's start a GoFundMe. Yeah, this is a good idea, guys. Listen, if you're listening and you're rich, donate to this, please.
So, like Brian said, to me, this is a good piece of advice. Maybe get one marathon show because they might be doing a show near you. They could be coming near you. You might want to wait on that unless you're a savage. And we've met the savages, and you guys are more hardcore than we are. I mean, we're not even going to lie. We don't even hide that fact. You guys are fucking – this is like what you spend your vacation hours on. That's awesome. Kill it, bro. Kill it.
Kill it.
They teased – you told me that they teased an album that's coming out. And you jumped on it. You got the notification on lock. You jumped on it immediately.
You know how that goes.
There's nothing. There's no information. I've already searched extensively. There's no information on it whatsoever. Shit. Brian knows something.
Somebody may have leaked.
Times in the podcast. Strap in, guys. No. Be quiet.
Alert.
Quiet. Put the popcorn down. Shut the fuck up.
Put it down. Everybody, relax. Somebody leaked from, it was from a German magazine. I don't remember what it was even called. What the title of the album should be, in the post. And it was so funny. I saw it the other day, like in their Instagram post, their last one, they put like a series of sentences, like a, what do you call this? For example, like G is for good boy. I is for ignorant. You know what I'm saying? Like, I can't remember what you call that right there. But if you look down the words, it read Gilgamesh, which is like an ancient character or whatever. And I was like, oh, you mean Gilgamesh? You know, always zinging over here. You know what I mean? Always Gilgamesh. Zinging. But you know what I mean? But the last, this was months ago, they said that their next album, when they dropped Petro, was going to be almost like an answer to Petro, but like with a very different sound. And then in this post, it's a bunch of pictures. I mean, there's like five pictures in a row of, it's the same picture of Joey. I saw a lot of synthesizers. So I think this one is going to be a very different record. Could they just be teasing us 100%? It's just Petrodroganic Part 2. Like, maybe. You know, we don't know yet. But I'm excited about this one, man. I have a lot of questions for you in regard of, like, and we'll talk about this in a second, what you want to hear next year. But you know how Gizzard goes, man. I mean, our answers today might be so irrelevant next year that it's okay. None of that mattered. But I'm excited about this, man. The synthy stuff I like. I've been crazy into this Petrodroganic, like kind of ever since it came out. I kind of can't stop listening to it, man. So that's kind of where I'm at. But I'm very excited about this new album. It'll be great, just like all their other ones. Better be.
Well, if the Gilgamesh thing is correct, I can definitely believe it. Yeah, I've heard right? that name before, and I remembered all this information off the top of my head.
That's so tight.
Ancient Sumerian, it's so tight. It's an ancient Sumerian story, I guess, and it's I've heard of the tales of Gilgamesh and the Epic of Gilgamesh. I've heard those terms. I've only heard that they were like a preference to Jesus and whatnot, and it was kind of like the first Jesus or something. But I don't really know. I don't know any of this fucking information. But basically, it's like an epic poem that was written 2000 BC, you know, like roughly 2000 before Christ even came. So like, you know, what's up,
throwback.
Christ? Do you even have a poem if Gilgamesh did it first? You know what I'm saying? If Biggie it was first, is Lil Wayne even a rapper? You know what I'm saying, dog? That's all I'm saying.
Damn.
You know, just put that
deep
in your mind. Put that in your Gilgamesh and smoke it, you know? Put that Gilgamesh in your pipe and smoke it, you little bitch. Sorry,
Buster.
Jesus, I didn't mean to call you. Sorry, don't do that. That's not what I meant. Take it back. Just lightning bolts my ass. So, we don't know anything about the album. You said are you hoping that it might be an answer to Petro?
They teased that. They've made a statement like that when Petro was coming out. It's like, yeah, the next
correct
one will be like kind of like the opposite. So that could, you know.
Correct.
They could have... That it might end up being down the road three albums later, because they ride on what they're feeling, man. So, you know, no, we're not holding them to nothing like that. But, yeah, that could be the case.
Gilgamesh makes sense with that, too, because he's a hero. It's a hero's tale, so maybe it's less of a Godzilla tale, where the monster's just kind of out and about trying to fuck shit up, and it's more of a hero's tale. That'd be cool. And
could
I don't...
Be.
That might be musically different, or it could be lyrically and thematically different. It could be both. It'll be interesting to see it regardless.
Yeah.
Let me ask
Agreed.
You something.
I'm excited for that.
In this upcoming marathon, specifically the marathon, the sets for the shows are going to be a lot different from the marathon sets. What are you looking forward to seeing new that maybe you haven't seen before, or you have seen in previous marathon sets or previous shows that they haven't done in a while and you want to see it come back again? What is, you know, and when I say new, I don't mean, you know, maybe one song. I guess I mean more like a jam that they've been doing, because lately
sure
they've been doing more jams where the song...
Jamming.
You showed me this thing on Spotify. I couldn't really access it completely because I don't have the premium version or whatever it is.
That's your second
bro
mistake.
Yeah, well, you don't fucking share your account with me, okay? So why don't you share your
Spotify
account with me, and then we can We'll be good, bro. We'll be good.
We'll be good. Even Steven, man.
Yeah. Yeah. There you go. There you go.
Don't talk to me, okay?
I got too many
accounts. Don't talk to me.
Netflix, HBO. I got all these stupid streaming things. I don't need to throw another one on there. Because, like, literally my phone just stays on. Sorry, guys. I'm about to blow your minds here. My thing stays on King Gizzard. So, like, I just listen to King Gizzard in my phone when I'm listening to music, generally speaking. Sorry. So, that's it.
Then, okay. Do that. Continue to do that. So, they added – I don't think we talked about this too much, and I'm sure a lot of people listening know this, but I'm sure plenty don't either. They have another page on Spotify now called Bootleg Gizzard.
Oh.
And they've – yeah, dude. So, they've upped Red Rocks, those Salt Shed shows, not Caverns yet. Dude, yes, and it's all just live Gizzard, hours and hours. So not all of them, but a lot of the bootleg shows are on there. Acoustic Night is on there and from Brisbane. Check it out, dude. Asheville, all those. So just shuffle that up on your Spotify. Very cool, man. That's great. All the live versions of all that sick stuff.
Bada bing, bada boom. Well, then, while I got you zoomed Gizzard up on the camera here, what songs or what jams do you want to hear in these upcoming marathon shows, Brian?
I have a particular vision. Let me tell you something, man. It's what I want to see them close. Yeah. As of today, whatever the date is today, September 20th maybe, some of that. Very cool. I want to see Austin closed with Flamethrower leading into Motor Spirit. You know, Flamethrower ends with the Motor Spirit. I wonder like how that ends, Flamethrower. I want that to mix right into – so like last track of the album – going into the first track of the album and just end with a Motor Spirit, I would be lit, ecstatic to see that, man. I feel like they'll you know how they like to do. They don't follow the rules, man. So like I said, last track of the album, swinging into the first one would be so damn cool. I think it would leave that crowd buzzing, bro. And Flamethrower has like the heavy, then it slows down, it like gets heavier but slows down again. And then hits you heavy again. It's just all over the place. I think it would be a really cool closer. So that's my super go-to. I need to see Dragon. I am itching to see Dragon. I don't care about when it closes or whatever, but I need to see that song live, man. I want to chant that Petro Dragonic Apocalypse. I need to do that. I need to, preferably outside. That feels like an outside thing. That needs to happen in my life. And classic Brian stuff. You can tell I've thought about this a little bit. The Gorge. It's such a beautiful outdoor venue, so I want to play that hippy-dippy shit that I love ever so much. Usually I would say close. I want to hear them open with Head on Pills. Yes, I've heard it. I got my White Whale. But give me a little Head on Pills to open up the Gorge
my
and just watch me.
Whale.
Found my White Whale, you know? But open Head on Pills at the Gorge. See you up there, brother. See you up there. That's all I got to say about that.
All right. I love it. I feel it. I breathe it. And I understand what you're saying. And I get how you can root for things at certain venues because you feel like the atmosphere is better for that venue. And I respect
yes.
that game. All right. If I were – and this is – follow me on this train. We might get a little deep in the sauce here. I would love to see this.
Let's do it.
Either piece together – in some kind of way, or put in a set. It could be separate. Could be together, could be separate. I'm okay with it. I want to see Supercell earlier in the show. I don't want to see it late. I want to see it early. I want to, like,
get going.
Mid, get it going. But, like, they play, like, four or five songs. Boom, Supercell.
Cool.
Somewhere in Supercell, I think they should... Bam! Gamma Knife, and not like right away, Gamma Knife,
sir.
But like, because that pit, when that happens, I'm talking about Austin because that's the show that I'm going to go to. Pit will start, it's already going to be going. But if you think about it from a Supercell is the storm, and they're literally talking about like a giant hurricane, you know, crazy tornado storm thing with a bunch of tornadoes within it. It's madness. And Gamma Knife, the video, a lot of turning in that. So I love that feeling, and the pit has that feeling. So,
Gamma Knife.
And then right after that, this is something we haven't seen in a very long time. And I think, oh, man, I'm getting chills. This is crazy.
Ooh.
I think it would erupt the fucking house if they played People Vultures in Austin. fucking popped the fuck off and played the whole thing top to bottom, back to back, and then bent that in. What do you think about that? You didn't have much of a reaction on that. Would you want to see that?
Sure. Oh my god. Sure, man. Yeah. Come on. Dude, it's me.
I haven't seen that in years.
People vultures.
Okay. I haven't seen that in years. If you can name the last time that you think you saw that full song, where they didn't just play the intro and outro and stop. They didn't play it in L.A. They haven't played it in a very long time in person that I've seen it. I think if they waited at the right amount of time, which it has been, and played that song, it would electrocute the fucking room. All right? You don't have to play the full fucking tune. But I think you should.
Maybe you do.
People
Maybe
Vulture.
You do.
Any formation of what you what you sent me, which was the Breaking Chain, or Great Chain of
Great
Being.
Chain of Being.
Breaking Chain. Great Chain of Being.
Flamethrower.
I'm sorry.
Motor Spirit. Yeah, dude. What they're doing with Gaia right now is the coolest shit I've seen from them.
That's the thing I want to see.
In a lot, dude. I can't remember what show it's in on the European tour, but I saw it live. Somebody recorded a great live video of it, and they start with Gaia. They go into, I want to say it was Gaia, Gila,
Gaia,
Dragon.
I got it right here. It's Gaia, Motor Spirit, Great Chain.
Yes.
Back into Gaia. So that, at the end of everything, right after People Vulture, Gaia, Motor Spirit, Great Chain of Being, back into Gaia. So Supercell.
Fire, huh?
It's a fat lineup if you're asking me, but
the crowd is exhausted.
I mean, everyone's gonna be exhausted. Supercell, Gamma Knife, People Vulture, Gaia. Holy shit, bro! What the fuck? that would be so dope, dude. Motor Spirit and Great Chain back into Gaia. Okay, guys, and then throughout it, maybe have a Nonagon appear every once in a while and fuck with people a little bit. I think that would pop. The room would explode with energy. It would explode. People would not be able to contain themselves. Somebody might
not
be giving birth, be impregnated and give birth in the same night, just because of that. In the same room, all
it
because of that energy. The baby's able to
the
grow.
The baby's like, I gotta get out of here, bro.
Of
this
that,
is fire.
That fucking lineup. I believe in that lineup. That's what
support.
I want to see. That's
support.
I
have all support in the world for that. That sounds great.
Like, that's
so,
why
I'm
don't
there
like
for it.
Rocks, Tommy. Okay? Because you want to see
and
that
you
kind
see?
Of crazy shit.
Yeah, and listen, man. Now with the Nonagon stuff, because
by water.
They know what Nonagon Affinity means to them as a band, right? Obviously, that's a big one for them. A lot of people jumped on board through Nonagon. I mean, we idolized it for years. I still do. It's fucking amazing. I will say I feel like I've seen it again. I can't remember. You know, all this stuff is immense. But I know they ended, I want to say, the second Red Rock show, the ones that you and me were at before I couldn't go to the last one. They ended with the Nonagon stuff, right? So it was Robot Stop, Gamma, People Vultures,
they
Mr.
didn't play
B.
People Vultures.
I'm pretty sure, man.
I'm going to have to see the set list because I don't remember.
Yeah. Let's
all peep
it. I could be wrong. Maybe it went, I don't know. Definitely Gamma. I believe People Vultures, and that went into Mr. Beat. And they turned Mr. Beat into an Iron Lung Boogie.
I remember
and
this.
And Iron Lung. So like, whoa, that's so fucking cool that they could do that. That's goddamn awesome. So yeah, man, they're going to play with it. They're going to switch out a bunch of stuff. We're going to see stuff we've never seen from them, which is amazing. So, again, like I said earlier, all this stuff we're fabricating could be just so far off from what they're actually going to do one calendar year from now.
Because they're
going to
drop an album.
That's the fun part.
They're
going to
drop an album.
You know?
Yeah.
Yeah.
There,
minimum
there's new
one.
Stuff that's going to come. Minimum one. We know about one. So, like, that's for sure going to change any outcome and potential future shows. And, I mean, 100%, you know?
Of course.
I flipped through that.
Now, with these marathon sets, again, these are 3 hours, and they said no breaks. Like, you know, when we saw Red Rocks, those were like 15 minutes. They dropped Laminated Denim. No breaks this one for this tour. So it's 3 hours, just pure rock and roll. Bring it to your fucking face, man. So, whew. Yeah, dude. Yeah.
I don't think anybody was asking them for that. I don't think anybody was.
No, this is all that. Dude. That's so them, bro. They're so like, yo, dude. There's other bands
saying like, hey, man. What's about what about this break? 15 minutes you're just sitting around not doing shit for? It's like, what,
dropping
dude?
A new album
like,
for us?
Nobody is saying that, bro. You guys can fucking kick it, have a beer, relax, dude. Take a shot. You know what I mean?
Please.
I get it. And then
take a shit. Yeah.
Doing stand up for an hour is a lot. And you got like between the first show and the second show, usually you get a fat fucking break between
oh,
that
yeah.
happening. It's not 15 minutes, bro. So, like, what they're doing, an hour and a half, 15 minutes, and then just fucking right back at it, dude. Like,
Super Saiyan, Super Saiyan.
Not a soul expects them on the planet Earth to do that, dude. Nobody
except them.
Insanity.
Except those six men on stage, dude. That's all it is, bro. It's all.
Maybe they just want to get it done faster. You know what I mean? They're just like, let's just get it over with, bro. I'm tired. I want to go home. Wouldn't it be so funny if they were just like that? I just want to go,
God,
I'm fucking tired.
Let's just do it, man. Let's just fucking do it, man. I'm sure there's been a day or two. I mean, what they've done,
we've seen
84,000 shows. Like,
we've seen it. I think there's been a couple times where we've seen them. You saw Cavs when he was sick as fuck, and I think that coming off of sickness, it happens.
It was kind of heroic, man. It was kind of heroic.
They're human beings, man. So, like, you're going to get – I've seen Stu, like – less into a show before, as funny as that sounds. Like he wasn't really fully engaged. Maybe I was wrong 100%, you know, but he just looked like he was like, I'd rather fucking be home right now. Or just backstage sleeping. He looked tired. And if you listen to Robot Stop, it's like that's what that song's about, is him
no shit
working his ass off. Being
the body's
mother.
Overworked, man. The body's overworked.
We hit everything on the list of topics to talk about, Brian. Is there anything else you wanted to add before we start to wrap this motherfucker up?
Man, honestly, that is kind of it, dude. I hear all the time, that like I said, I've been listening to Petro, like, not nonstop, but a decent amount, man. It's just like, I was talking about that show earlier that was kind of like what I sent you yesterday, but just a little, I think it was the first time they played Dragon, and it was just going Gaia, Gilla, Dragon, playing the whole thing, and then just like they took like a little break or whatever. And you at this point, Gaia was, you know, like 15 minutes ago, you know what I mean? And they just still kind of looks at the boys, just like, I am Gaia. And you're like, what the fuck is this again, dude? Like, oh man, it's just like, whoa, because I've had my feelings about the heavy stuff. Like, man, I just miss that, like, that real trippy chill giz. Nah, dude, that's so behind. It's so behind. I want to see it all, I want to hear it all. They're gonna throw in Rat's Nest into all these songs. All the stuff you were talking about, like with the, all the Nonagon stuff. You know they're gonna throw in a Venusian 2. They'll throw a little Self-Immolate into all that stuff, and it's just gonna be, an hour and a half, 2 hours of those marathon. Some of those marathon shows that are just, bring a tall water, and get inebriated, but also know your limits, man. Because those 3 hours are gonna be hydrate, daddy-o's. Okay. It's going to be a lot. It's going to be a lot. And I just, man, it's a year away, and I'm like, I need this for myself, for my sanity. I need to have, like, things on the horizon to look forward to besides, like, the mundane stuff. So this is a good one for me right now, man. I'm really excited. We got preparation to do with a lot of cool stuff. I'm happy, man. I'm stoked.
That's what's up.
Let's fucking get it.
Yeah, no, I'm excited, too. I think this next year of shows and the podcast is going to be really exciting. We're going to add a few new little things and tanks. We're going to add some new episode type deals. It's going to be good. It's going to be a good time. I'm excited for King Gizzard and what they're going to put out. What you said about Petro in particular, about the heavy stuff, this is more like Great Chain of Being. And I'm glad that they solidified my thought with that. I think I said that on the podcast when we were doing the review, is that it reminded me of Great Chain of Being a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
And it's one of my favorite King Gizzard songs because it's religious, and I think it's just so funny when they talk about religion in a not metaphorical but a realistic way. It's not fantasy.
Oh, I love that. That's one of my favorite Gizzard.
Describing it as if it was real. It's very cool. I really really enjoy that type of, I don't know what to call that, a simile or something like that. Something smarter than I'm capable of putting out there. But I think it's really interesting that they do that. And then they saw how lyrically it matched up so well with Petro. And it's the same themes, that bigger than you themes. That was a lot different than Infest the Rat's Nest. And some of the themes in Infest the Rat's Nest I had more of a problem with. And it was less fantasy-based, I guess. Maybe that's what my problem with. But I couldn't put my finger on it, and I don't know if I can put my finger on it right now, but I like Petro way more than Rat's Nest. Way more. To me, it's not even close. And I think in the other podcast, the way I put it was, it feels cleaned up. It feels intentional. It feels like Stu wrote a novel and then made a soundtrack for that novel. It's so well put together and organized and orchestrated. I love it. I love that album so fucking much. I love the characters in it. I can see them in my fucking mind.
Same, same.
It's the shit. And I not taking away from other albums. Fishing for Fishies is still one of my favorite albums. But and it's not that sound, you know. Neither
no.
is Polygon Wanaland. They're not even if a direct comparison to Nonagon, which there's some we can poke out some similarities, but this is a different realm and a different level of expertise. And I hope that they keep going in that direction, whether it be a softer sound or not. I love the organization and thought behind it, but I do love the jam albums as well. I love it all, baby, and I'm here for it.
We love it all.
You guys are here for it. Thanks a lot for listening to us talk today. Brian, you fucking crushed, as always. I love all the news and all the details and all the other shit that you got going on.
We did it, buddy. We're good, man.
Fucking crushing it. 100%. We're doing it. Thank you guys for listening to the show again. We fucking love you. Have a great day. Have a great week. Have a great, I don't know, until we see you next time. Fuck yeah, bro.
See you at the rock show, baby.
Yeah, no, go. We'll talk about that more. But we'll see you in Austin for sure. We'll see you in Austin. We're not going to do a podcast until then. I'm just going to hold off until the Austin show. So. All right, guys. We'll talk to you soon. Peace.
Bye.
Hey, I'm going to go buy some rocks.
Fuck yeah. Give me a big one.